Hey guys, welcome to my channel Movie Downer, and soon the Eternals movie will be coming on November 5th, and today we are going to talk about the 15 most powerful Eternals ranked. So without wasting any time, let's begin the video. Flight in the morning, I see what you've been trying to do, and I'm a mission to border. You think I never pay attention? In my mind, I'm recording. I'm about to win and ruin all your goals and dreams out of boredom. Riding around my homies like we run the city, looking fresh and feeling like a millie. Moving silence, you can never hear me. If you got a problem when you see me. So guys, the first character is Droog. Droog is more antagonistic Eternal, somewhat comparable to the Maximus, the Mad of the Inhumans. He is the power-hungry schemer whose plans have led to the retirement of other Eternals on the several occasions. Regardless, he has mostly been allowed to remain among the Eternals. That was until Icarus finally grew tired of Droog's actions and led attack on him in comics. Droog's greatest powers are Linus telepathy and matter transportation. He is the great manipulator and can alter matter with great precision. He can also emit a kind of flame that hurts other Eternals. And we all know that Droog will appear in the Eternals movie, and it will be interesting to see how Loki or Maximus-like villain will betray the Eternals and help the other Deviants. And our next character is Grom, aka the Overmind. Grom is also known as the Overmind, is the union of the billion Eternal minds. Eternal have the ability to form the ultra-powerful entity called Unimind, and the Overmind is perversion of that concept. Given this identity, the Overmind excels at telepathy, mental control, precognition, psychokinetic projection. Grom is being of immense mental power through the he lacks some of the other abilities that Eternal possesses. The Overmind has largely been an agonistic force as well. He battled likes of the Fantastic Four, the Defenders, the Scorching Supreme. However, he always been pivotal in saving the world alongside with the Thunderbolts when the Grandmaster attacked the Earth in comics. The next character is Eros, aka Star Fox, has been a longtime member of Avengers in the comics and is also known as the brother of Thanos. Eros has the powers of other Eternals, but he is mostly known for his ability to manipulate the minds and prod the pleasure centers of other sentient beings. Despite the somewhat ominous nature of those powers, he almost always been a hero. But in recent comics, he became an anti-hero because of the death of Thanos, as it was known that Thanos was killed by Gamora or Guardians of the Galaxy. To take the revenge of his brother's death, he tried to kill the Guardians of the Galaxy or Gamora. But in the last, it was known that Thanos was faking his death to kill the Guardians of the Galaxy. And in last, Star Fox and Guardians of the Galaxy team ups and defeat are Thanos. So guys, there are also some chances that Star Fox will appear in recent Eternals, because there are some rumors that young Thanos will appear, and we all know that Star Fox is the brother of Thanos, and there are some chances that a young Star Fox will appear in Eternals, as we all know that Athena is also appearing in Eternals movie, who is the cousin of Thanos. The next character is Ed Kroer, aka Ultimus, is a Kree Eternal who has been both a hero to the Kree and enemy of the humans. He is not initially malevolent, but his loyalty to the Kree has brought him into a conflict with the Avengers, Thor and others. Although he is an Eternal, he has never shown any allegiance to the Eternals of the Earth or Titan. Ultimus is a powerful being and has shown to be a strong to even hurt likes of Thor and her colleagues. He can use the cosmic powers and radioactive energies for a variety of purposes, including energy blasts, force fields, healing, and size and mass manipulation. The next character is Zuras, who is the leader of other Eternals. In the comics, like other Eternals, he is a very powerful being with an endless lifespan. He is also the first to initiate the Unimind and was the only Eternal who could initiate the Unimind. He was also the most powerful energy manipulator of the Eternals. In the recent comics, he recently killed himself due to some reasons, which we will not get into it. But I don't think so that he will be the leader of Earth Eternals in the movie of the Eternals, because In the Trail of the Eternals, we can easily see, and it is specified that Ajok will be the leader of the Earth Eternals, and she is also able to initiate the Unimind. So I'm not sure that he will be the leader of the Earth Eternals, but I think so that there will be any reference to the Earth Eternals or the Zuras in the movie. So the next character is Interloper. He's the one of the Earth's Eternals, but close not to deal with any of them outside of a friendship with Gilgamesh, one of his key enemies, with the Dragon of the Moon, who Interloper found on numerous occasions, including by the side of the Eternals of Titan. After what he thought that was his final battle with the dragon, he became a hermit and lived away from everyone. Interloper has the most of the powers of the Eternals of Earth, but he also has some specialized powers due to the discipline and training. As with all Eternals, he is immortal. He has super strength, but only in the 40 tons range. One of his impressive abilities is including fear in those around him that is so intense and they won't even attempt to face him. The next character is Gilgamesh, who will be appearing in the MCU Eternal movie portrayed by Don Lee in Marvel Comics. Gilgamesh is also as known as the Forgotten One and is one of the strongest and most durable of the Eternals. While the Gilgamesh does not have a lot of fans, he is basically the Eternal version of Thor, who is pretty strong or powerful. Gilgamesh is physically the strongest of the Eternals and has the strength to easily lift over 100 tons. Is considered the most powerful Earth Eternals, is immortal and does not age, and is immune to the most of the Earth diseases. He also has a regenerative healing factor. The next character is Cersei. Cersei is possibly the most famous member of the Eternals for one big reason. She was a member of the Avengers in Marvel Comics, and we all know that she will be appearing in the Eternals movie. In comics, she is a sorcerer who left the Eternals to live among the humans. Cersei is almost immortal and indestructible. She also possesses super strength, durability, but on a smaller scale of beings like Gilgamesh. She possesses the power of telepathy and can control weaker minds to be her bidding. She also has the skills of illusion and is considered a class 4 or 5 when it comes to the Eternals with their power. The next character is Makari. Makari is the third member of the Eternals that will be in the MCU movie portrayed by the Walking Dead actor Lauren Ridloff. The actor was male in the comics but is female in the film as the first deaf MCU superhero. Makari is the one member of the Eternals that loved to interact with the humans the most and often visited Earth to help and teach humans various skills. He has the superhuman strength with the ability to lift about 30 tons. However, his key power is super speed, which he has boosted to almost unprecedented levels. The next actor is Ikaris. Ikaris is another Eternal that will appear in the MCU movie. He is the most popular of the Eternals when it comes to Marvel Comics fans. Ikaris is one of the most powerful superheroes in the Eternals and one of their greatest fighters. To prove how strong he is, Ikaris defeated the first mutant, Acoplex. Ikaris is also the one of the Eternals that believes who they should play the role of the superheroes and often clashes with Hina when it comes to their position of the world. Richard Madden plays Ikaris, and if you want to know how powerful he is, he also has defeated Silver Surfer in the pages of Marvel Comics. The next character is Thane. Thane is a hybrid. He is an Eternal, but he is also happens to be an Inhuman. Thane is son of Thanos and an Inhuman woman who returned pregnant with his child after two sides clashed. Thane ended up incredibly powerful because of this, but had little control over his power at first as they were unstable. The powers that Thane gained as an Inhuman after undergoing telekinesis were deadly. He had the power of the dead touch, where anyone touched with his left hand died. When he lost control, anyone close to him was in danger of being killed. Thane's right hand left people in a stage of living death. On top of that, he possessed Eternal's power of immortality and more than. The next character is Ajok. Ajok is another member of the Eternals who get a gender swap on the way to the MCU. In this case, it is Salma Hayek who portrays the great warrior on the big screen. In the comics, Ajok was considered the greatest warrior in the history of the Eternals. Ajok was so powerful that he was awakened from the long slumber when the Eternals needed to defeat the Deviants. He was at once time corrupted by the Deviants and slaughtered many Eternals as an unstoppable assassin. He even defeated the Thor in a battle. The next character is Thanos. The biggest surprise for people who don't read the comics is that Thanos is an Eternal. He is not one of the Earth's Eternals, obviously, but he is one of the Eternals of Titan. In the MCU, Thanos already proved to be the single most powerful being in the universe, taking all of the Earth's mightiest heroes to defeat him in Avengers Endgame. Thanos was not only the one of the Eternals of Titan, but he was born with Deviant Syndrome. The Eternals version of someone born a mutant. In the end, the Deviants are the counterparts of Eternals. Thanos is easily the most powerful of Titan's Eternals, who can manipulate the cosmic energy and has increased powers due to the death resurrecting him. And next character at the first position is Kronos. The most powerful member of the Eternals in Marvel Comics is Kronos, and isn't even close. Kronos ruled the Eternals heirs in the past with his brother Uranus. However, when war broke out between the brothers, with Uranus wanting war and Kronos wanting peace, Uranus lost and Kronos became the ruler of Earth. However, an accident in his lab destroyed Kronos' physical body and he became one with the universe itself. Kronos has an intellect that is superior to any human, as well as any cosmic awareness and telepathy. He can control decreased humans and can exert control over time. Thanos compared Kronos' power to that of Galactus. So guys, this was the whole video. If you like it, like, subscribe and share the video. And now we will meet you in next video. Till then, see you.